Hello, everybody. This is Alex Cequea, editor-in-chief of iPhone Life magazine. I'm sitting here with Jess Moore. She's the co-founder of Stylebook, which is an app, a closet management app. And she's going to tell us all about that. And she's also going to tell us a little bit about her professional photography background and iPhone photography, and hopefully give us some tips to take better iPhone photography. How you doing, Jess?
I'm doing great. Thanks for having me.
Thank you for being here. So tell me a little bit about this app. So what is a closet management app? I'm a guy, so my closet is not managed.
Hey, we have Stylebook for men now too. But it's basically a virtual closet for your real life wardrobe. So what you do is you keep images of all the individual pieces of clothing inside the app. And then there are tools in there to help you remove the background, and then you can make outfit collages so you can save all your favorite outfits and sort of plan into the future what you're going to wear. So then it makes getting dressed super fast, and then you can get like insights based on using the calendar feature. So the more you use the calendar, the more information you find out about how you're wearing what you already own. So you can find out, okay, well, maybe it wasn't worth it to buy that $500 pair of shoes because I only wear them once. So it wasn't a good investment. Or, like, you know that you really want a pair of jeans because you wear them so much, so you should get a new one.
Cool. And the camera is an essential part of the functionality, right? So basically, you're taking pictures of your wardrobe items?
That's right. So you can use a digital camera also, but the easiest way is to actually use the built-in iPhone camera to take like a quick snapshot of the individual piece of clothing. And we have like a whole like instruction manual of how to get the best type of pictures using the app. So it's like essential, like the better your pictures look, basically, the more useful Stylebook will be to you because you'll get an accurate portrayal of what the individual pieces of clothing look like. So like if everything kind of looks like a dark blob, like it's not so useful anymore, like when you're out at the store trying to figure out whether or not you own a gray t-shirt already, like you won't be able to tell which one is which if it's not a clear picture.
Yeah. And when you guys started the app, this app has been out for a few years, right?
Yeah, it came out in October 2009. Although I have to say that way back then, that it's actually kind of funny. Like if you happen to have downloaded it then and saw what it looks like, it's a very different. Like I think at that time we probably only had like 4 or 5 features, but now the app actually has over 90 features. So it's like vastly more sophisticated now than it was way back when.
How was it incorporating the camera then in 2009 versus now, since the camera has steadily improved in quality?
My co-founder and I were just talking about this the other day because the function of the camera was the same when the app first came out, but as you mentioned, the hardware was much worse, let's just say, because the photos, it wasn't as easy to get such a clear, bright photo as it is with, let's say, the 4S. But we also learned a little bit as developers that we had to provide sort of tips and instructions to help our users get a better picture, because it's not just the hardware when it comes to taking photography. It's also the environment that you take the picture in, and you really have to sort of pay attention to your surroundings when you're taking a photo. It's really easy, but it's just something you have to think about.
So tell me a little bit about your background with photography. You studied it in school, you did some professional photography work?
Yes, so I went to NYU. My major was photography and imaging, which is the photo program there at Tisch. So when I was there, I loved working on lighting, and that was like sort of my specialty. And believe it or not, like most of my work as a student, I took pictures of inanimate objects. So it's kind of fitting that now Perfect. The program that I made is like right for just taking pictures of clothes. And then while I was in school, I interned in the Vogue magazine photo department. So that dealt with a lot of photo research, actually. And then after that, after graduation, I worked in the Lucky Art Department, which is Lucky Magazine. It's a fashion magazine, also by Condé Nast. And when I worked there, I dealt a lot with the retouching. So I passed on retouching notes, and my job was sort of to make sure that when the photos were going out to the printer, that they had the correct instructions to kind of enhance them and make them look better. So like a lot of photos, you'll be surprised, they're not as perfect as you would hope when you get them, and it needs a little bit of post work. So through that experience, I sort of learned, do all you can before you're done taking the pictures, because it's really gonna improve the work and make it easier for you in the end, like when you have the finished product. Like, you don't want to have to spend a few hours working on it on the computer. You want to just spend like a minute. So like, it's very important to do it right the first time, I'd say.
Yeah, totally. And especially with the iPhone camera, what kind of tips do you have for us in terms of setting up the shot? And you said you were really into lighting. So, and lighting is very important, especially for the iPhone camera. What kind of tips do you have
for us? I would say that, like, lighting, as you said, is paramount. It's number one. Like, you have to make sure that you take your picture in a bright environment. Because especially for point-and-shoot cameras and for the built-in iPhone camera, the picture is just going to look a lot more vibrant and colorful, and you'll get a more accurate color reading. So, like, for example, if you're taking a picture of a brown shirt in a dim, dark environment, that shirt might look gray or black. So you really want to make sure that the light is bright, and also that it's daylight, because a lot of people don't realize this, but something that I learned in photo school is that different artificial lights have different burning temperatures, so they actually appear different in photographs. So a fluorescent light will make everything sort of look green. And it's something that, like, when in real life, you don't really notice it that much. You really have to kind of look, and your eye has to be trained to see it. But you'll notice if you look at something that's white, it will have sort of a kind of greenish, almost like a neon tint. And the same thing happens with everyday lamps. So when, like, the tungsten lamps that most people have in their house, it gives everything an orange cast. And most people kind of like that when you're in the environment. Like, it makes you feel very warm and nice. But when you're taking a picture and you're depending on it looking sort of accurate and, like, beautiful or nice, like, you really want the colors to look the way you perceive them in real life. And the only way that you can really do that with a point-and-shoot camera without post-Photoshop work is to take it in bright daylight. So, and in terms of Stylebook, I'll give you our top tips. Okay, so the first is, like I said, lighting. Bright, even lighting. So try to, when you look at the picture, I sort of like to take one test image and then look at it on the screen, because sometimes you can't really tell when you're in real life, like, what's going on, you know? So you might notice, oh, actually, my shadow's in the, like, the bottom third of the picture, so you know to, like, kind of move and then retake it. And the other thing is that when you're taking pictures for Stylebook, use a solid background. So, like, if you're going to take a picture of this blazer, it's a dark blazer, you would use, like, a light color that strongly contrasts with the blazer. Like, I usually use bed sheets or something like that, because it's, like, a big white surface, and everybody has sheets, so that's a good thing to use. And then also focus. So a lot of times people will take the picture really quick, and they're sort of moving their hand when they're taking the picture, and then you'll notice that the image will look fuzzy. And when something looks fuzzy like that, it can look, you might not be able to tell, like, the details on it. Like, let's say that shirt really has, like, pinstriping, or, like, you really wanted to be able to see the beads on the neckline or something like that. These are details that can be lost if you don't focus the picture. And a lot of people don't know that when you use the iPhone, you can actually tap the screen and it will refocus the image where you want, where you've touched it with your finger. So, like, what I like to do is I'll take my first little test shot, and then afterwards, once I have it lined up and I'm happy that, like, you know, my foot's not in it or whatever, like, something like that, then I'll make sure I'll just tap the garment really quick before I take the photo, and then it'll be in focus. So those are my number one tips, I'd say.
Cool. What about, what kind of, you talked a little bit about, or you mentioned to me earlier about getting feedback from your users and kind of learning from that in terms of your app. What kind of things did you learn? What kind of feedback did your users give you?
This is a, I mean, I'm sure everybody who has gone to school for something or has a lot of experience in something, not that I'm the master of photography, but like I just have more experience than the average person, I'd say, is like you forget that a lot of people, they might not realize that their pictures aren't top notch, you know, like they, to them, how they saw it in real life is what they're expecting to see when, after they take the photo, no matter what amount of effort you've put into like taking the picture.
Yeah.
So what I was discovering is like, I wasn't, when we first made the background removal tools, I personally didn't have any problems with it because I, at the time, I was using an SLR camera to take like rare, like high quality pictures, like, you know, basically with semi-professional lighting setup. So I was like, oh, of course my pictures look perfect. They look like a catalog. Why wouldn't everybody's? But I was realizing that most of our users, I'd say 90% of our users, were actually using the phone camera. So I became more aware that it was really important for me to sit down and try to see how people use it. So like I would kind of like conduct my own little focus groups too, where I would have people take pictures and see how they were doing it. And also if someone wrote to us and said, hey, like, listen, I'm having a lot of trouble getting the background to remove smoothly. What's going on? Does it not work? I would say, well, send me the picture and let me see what it looks like. And most of the time I discover a few things. So one was that a lot of people were not using the proper backgrounds. So sometimes people would just like have it hanging in the closet, like, you know, just like in a regular scene. So I realized I need to be more clear with those instructions. And also the, I know I keep talking about this, but I can't stress enough the lighting thing. A lot of people, they take their pictures at night because it's after work, after school, so they're just like in their bedroom, like, you know, like tossing it on the floor and taking a picture. And I realized that I had to be sort of a little bit more educational, like in the tutorials when I was sharing how to take the photos. And I think that feedback from the users is really important. And like as a developer, I'd say it's like gold, basically, because you may think that you can use it, because but you made it. Of course, you, like, you know, like, obviously, Bill and I, my co-founder and I, know how to use the app perfectly, every single function, but a user has never seen it before, especially new users. So we had to sort of step into their shoes and, like, realize that they don't have photography experience, and they want the best results with the least amount of time, sort of, which is reasonable. I mean, I will want that too.
Yeah, absolutely. People want it to be easy, and you found that you had to kind of educate them to make that as easy as possible for them. That's great.
Right.
So if people want to get this app, they can either go to stylebook.com.
It's or stylebookapp.com.
Stylebookapp.com, or search for it in the App Store.
That's right. And like I said before, we have a version for women and also a version for men.
All right, great. So I can get my closet organized.
That's right. No excuses now. You can do it.
Well, thank you very much for chatting with us, Jess. And good luck with the app. And thank you so much for giving us these great tips.
Thank you. And I had a lot of fun.
All right. Take care.
Thanks, you too.